One of these days, I'm going to start one of these videos with an explanation that I have cracked the secret to avoiding junk food, but it's not today. Last Sunday, my kid made chocolate brownies, and I was at that point 10 days into my intermittent fasting, clean eating regime. It was all going very well. I thought I should have one just to be polite. That's my excuse for that one. No excuse for the other 18 that followed. And then just the descent into calorie surplus hell for 4 days. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, written off, disaster. Got to Thursday yesterday, thought I need to get back on it here, if for no other reason than I'd eaten all the food in the house, even the cooking chocolate had gone. And then two cool things happened which helped me along. Firstly, my little labels arrived. They're for the bike. You bought one and it was quite expensive, and if you bought more they got cheaper and cheaper. So I have hundreds of the things. I've stuck them everywhere. Talking of the bike, I've also got some cool new aero bars. Carbon fiber, all very cool. We're going to talk a bit more about those though when I ride the bike on a long ride at the weekend, when I test them out, along with stickers, which will hopefully give me a few extra watts. And talking of watts, the other cool thing that happened was that TrainerRoad threw up a ramp test for me to take. Now, doing a ramp test to establish my FTP, my functional threshold power, after 4 days of binge eating is probably not the most sensible time to do it. But I kind of thought, do you know what, if I do it and I do badly, it serves me right. So let's just have a go and see how I get on. Now my FTP, in fact my bike riding history in general, looks like this. It's short, so don't blink. 6 months ago, I have no bike other than an e-bike that I used to go on picnics with Jen and the dogs. The only bike before that had been a Dawes Disco, but that was 33 years ago, so we don't need to count that. Then 6 months ago, the Wahoo Kickr arrives. After a week, I take an FTP test and I get 199, which despite the aerodynamic haircut, I am told is not particularly good. So motivated to improve on that. Just 2 months later, I take another FTP test and this time get 255 watts. And then 6 weeks ago, I took my last one and got 285 watts, starting to get into the realms of being slightly a bit more respectable. So yesterday, with just 6 months cycling behind me, I jump into the test with an expectation, or rather a hope, of getting to 300. That would be a good number to hit. It feels like a number that suggests that you cycle a bit. It's a bit like a 22 minute 5K to me. It's a number that says you're not fast as such, but you're equally someone that clearly runs a bit. You can't just get off a couch and go and do that if you've not trained for it at least a bit. So a degree of respectability. So here is how an FTP ramp test works. You start off with a very straightforward warm-up, and then every minute the power increases. So the app will tell the bike automatically to increase the resistance, requiring you to generate more watts. All you need to do is keep pedaling at whatever cadence you are comfortable with until you simply cannot pedal anymore. Every 60 seconds the wattage gets harder and harder, and there will simply come a point where you cannot turn the pedals. At that point, the ramp test is over. The app then uses a fancy algorithm calculation thing to work out what your FTP is based on those results. Now, your FTP, your functional threshold power, is theoretically the level of wattage you could pedal at consistently for 1 hour. Clearly, the ramp test is much shorter than that in duration, so it has to take you far beyond your current FTP level to work out where your FTP should actually be set at. All I could remember from the last time I did the test was that I failed before the ramp got to the 400 watt level, so I had that as a sort of vague target in mind as I went into it. So all is going well and I'm plodding along going up the ramps, heart rate is doing fine, feeling good. And then at 13 minutes in, the ramp gets to my current FTP, which is 285, and suddenly it does start to feel like hard work. And it just keeps on piling the effort on every 60 seconds. By 17 minutes, my heart rate is around 160 and doing 353 watts, and I am seriously starting to doubt that I'm going to get past the 400 watt ramp. And then at 19 minutes, my heart rate 172, 387 watts, the next ramp is going to be that 400 watt ramp, and I have a brainwave. I get Alexa to fire up the Rocky IV soundtrack.
Come on! Come on!
I don't know if you need to have been 13 years old when Rocky IV came out to be motivated by the music, but it does seem to help. If you can watch the training montage and see Duke yelling "no pain" while Rocky does the dragon flag,
no pain,
and not want to go and exercise, then there's something wrong with you. And I crushed it. I got all the way through the 403 ramp, did a minute at that. I then got into the 420 ramp and did a minute at that as well. Moved to the next ramp. And died immediately, but got way further than I thought. So my new FTP is now 316, 316 watts, which I'm really pleased with. I stuck it into the cycling analytics website that gives you a sort of comparison against other people. I am well inside the top 20%, so happy with that. My watts per kilogram is still pretty low, but there's not an awful lot I can do about that. I am clearly just much heavier than the average cyclist. At 6'6", if I had the upper body size and weight of an average cyclist, it would all just look a bit, I don't know, it wouldn't look like this, and my wife would leave me. So I have to just put up with that one. So 316 watts, very happy with that. I'm actually now not quite sure where it leaves me with music. I'd got to a point of thinking I don't need it. And now I'm wondering, actually, maybe I should drop it in occasionally as a tool in my exercise bag. Maybe for when I want to go and do some really hard efforts, having some music, if it can help, it can help. I'm now actually wondering whether I could use it to get under my 5-minute mile target. That might be interesting. In fact, I've got a run to go and do today. I've got a 45-minute gentle run supposed to be doing today, but putting the video together and looking at training montages from Rocky films on YouTube, all I can think of doing is just going out and crushing that run, which I shouldn't do because my legs still hurt from doing the test on the bike yesterday, and it's supposed to be a gentle run, and I only have one of my earphones, I've lost the other one. So going out and doing a fast run, pretending I'm Dolph Lundgren is probably pointless. Although, no pain. Fire, 42 dead, 12 seconds off my PB, second fastest 10K ever. Only one earpiece, no warm-up, ill-prepared, yelling instructions to my kid because he didn't know where he was going for directions. Still fast. I'm not sure if that's scientifically the reason I was so quick, but it is good enough for me. My next step is to start playing Rocky to myself every time I want to eat a brownie.